in the midst of poverty, so much poverty, even when times were normal, there was virtually nothing. The health sector was virtually zero. And now we have this epidemic, which is killing so many families, wiping out so many families. Every day I have updates from my friends who are in the government, some in the local business sectors. What is happening now in my hometown, Kenema, a population of about 120,000 people, is quarantined. Nobody should go out of Kenema because of the fear of spreading the epidemic. Nobody trusts anyone. They don't trust the health workers. They don't trust even, you don't even trust your own family. As you mentioned, Jalagima, yes, it's a small village. I would say a population of about 600-700 people only. They don't have drinking water. They don't have electricity. When someone is affected by this disease, especially in such a small community, they have a local custom and tradition of washing the body, performing their local custom of anointing the body, and then going to lay the person to rest. By touching the body, they are transmitting this virus. So health workers coming out telling them, don't touch the body. For them, it's a taboo. We want to touch our loved ones. We want to give them the final hug before we lay them to rest. But the health workers are saying no. So there's a conflict between the health workers and the traditional people. So we need to sensitize these people, let them know that this is an epidemic. You don't have to touch the body. When someone dies, leave it to the health workers to bury. So that's the conflict there, right there. When you look at the situation, especially in the villages, they don't believe that this is something that is coming from within. They believe it's coming from outside by coming from the West, and that the West are infecting them with these. But it's coming out of eating local animals, bush animals like monkey, insects that the people eat because they don't have food. Because the people are not literate. There's no television. Even if you have a radio, you don't have money to buy a battery. So you have to wait until someone comes from outside. They have this local town crier, go with a loudspeaker, talk to the people. It's fine. They have to do that. But they need to educate them. Also, if they quarantine the people, they need to allow food to come in. The government needs to provide all these resources. Because if you quarantine these people, they don't have food coming in, they don't have water. They're going back to the streams. And these streams are infected. They're going back to eating the bush animals. So you have to provide something for them. Dr. Khan, that was well known, who sacrificed himself, 39-year-old man. He died 2 weeks ago, very sad. And Dr. Cole died 2 days ago. So many nurses have died because they don't have the protective gear. They don't have the tools to work with. They're just managing. Because at this moment, when there is no cure, we just look up to God. I mean, people have so much faith. They're so strong in their belief. I mean, when they cry to God. I have been on the on Facebook, on social media with some of my friends in the East Coast. We pray for an hour or two every Saturday. We got the Imams, the Muslims, we got the Christians. I lead a Christian prayer, and then we discuss events that are taking place. So we have to pray. Sierra Leone, ke Liberia, ke Guinea, ke Nigeria. Do I say where in Guinea? Pema se wabi majifa, pipia, muboda, ti koga, bo in Guinea. Mukola ke high binale, komango, bo mama, in Guinea bo amu luemo. Nasa ti ha Dr. Khan, Dr. Ko, nasa ti ti. Be Vima call in Big Wadway now. And Tiha Dile Gilligan Loudway. Mag Wolver called War, Mabu Fama in Biggie, Big Wamor Wang. Mo high my jaw, now I be Bill Mugama. Now I delay. Now I am we call Go Yena Dile Bomma. Bom ma dai de mau ma begama. Nya be veima. Farimi a gabi veima. Ko. Bilo ko la mama. Ko hingbeji ibu amul weo. Muhai ma ajo. daily. Obama Jesu Christi by John. Amina.